channel, do you notice anything different? Okay, my hands are a dead giveaway because I wanted to play with this Kevin Murphy color chalk today. Today, I wanted to share with you how you can achieve this pink ombre hair look, and it's completely temporary. So if you're unsure about trying different colored hair and you're just like me, a little bit afraid, I'm going to show you how you can get this done. So the first thing you want to do is to change your shirt. And with video magic, I'm all changed. This can get a little messy. All right, here goes. So I'm just going to grab some sections and just rub it into my hair like this. Whoa, that's pretty crazy. Press it in with my thumb and my finger. Really concentrating on the ends. Wow. That's pretty crazy. Looks pretty good. I've just done a couple more strands, and as you can tell, my fingers are already getting pretty pink. My hands are getting very messy right now, and this does stain your clothes, so be very, very careful. But I'm really loving the turnout from this product. It's super, super cool. So all you have to do is lightly press into your hair, and if you want a more concentrated color like that, just leave it. Or if you want it to look a little bit more soft, just brush it out with your fingers and kind of rub it in. The texture of my hair has definitely changed because you can definitely feel that there's something in my hair now. Like, it's a little bit more coarse, thick. Down because it's so messy. Look, it's staining my clothes. Alright, now that I've finished more of the front side, I'm going to move on to the back because the back is still pretty black and I want it to look a little bit more even. Ahead, I'm just going to rub it in. And I obviously can't see right now, so I have to blend it in later. And don't forget the insides because your hair will show from the back side too. Alright, now taking some bobby pins, I'm going to pin up the back of my bun so I have that illusion of a faux bob. So now that you have your loose bun, slowly just fold it inwards. So it looks something like this. Taking your bobby pins, just start pinning that back. To loosen it up a bit so that it looks a little bit more realistic. So this is pretty much the final look. All right, so you guys are zoomed in right now so you can really see my hair and how it looks. So I've been told that this color bug will only probably last me one or two uses, and I barely used any of it and I still got the color that I did. So it's been a little while since I did my hair, and I wanted to just give you guys a quick update and also some tips and tricks if you're interested in purchasing this hair chalk. Don't comb your hair, and I learned that the hard way, because when I combed my hair after I used the hair chalk, all of the chalk ended up back on the comb, so it was pretty much like wasting your effort. So if you really want to comb out your hair, I would suggest doing that first. Second, if you're interested in styling your hair, style it, curl it, straighten it, anything, do that first before you apply the hair chalk. The powder would come off onto the flat iron, so it wasn't really working as well. And my last tip for you guys is definitely use a towel, because This is a very messy process, but overall I absolutely love the color and the outcome. Everyone on Instagram also seems to love it as well. So let me know what you guys think down below of the pink hair, if I should make it a permanent change, if I should do a pastel color. What do you guys think? Leave that down below. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a big thumbs up. If you're interested, I have an Instagram. My username is FashionByAlly. And if you want to watch my previous video, it will be linked over there. And if you're new to my channel, definitely subscribe. I upload once a week. And this is Allie, and I'll talk to you next time.